Should I?
Yeah, please do.
Yeah. Good morning. This is Crafting Macula with Crafting. Let's see how we did it. I don't have any financial interest of any product and material shown here. The background is that macula hole surgery with classic island peeling technique is not very uncommon in wear surgeries. But there are some situations when the classic technique, they fail. Especially when you have a large size of the hole and post-operative poor positioning or the inadequate ILM peeling, the result, the percentage varies from 5 to 10% in this failure cases. This collage shows the pre-operative and post-operative picture, OCT picture, showing how this is a non-closure of hole. And the prevailing technique as of now is having autologous blood or lens capsular flap or autologous ILM peeling to put into this open plug. This is a technique where a free ILM flap is being put into this open hole area and reposited with a soft tip cannula. It fills the gap and the OCT shows a closure of this open macula hole, but actually SDOCT clearly demonstrated that there is no retinal tissue, it is filled with the scar tissue only. So with this background, so the purpose is to need for finding out a better option for treating these failed macula hole cases, and an innovative idea popped up. So we have designed a special macular retinal trephine of different sizes, and then we measured the preoperative hole size, that is a failed macula hole cases. And then we predetermine the hole size with one rest of the areas at 23 gauge and one hole, one port was made with 20 gauge. And this trephine was, there was a gentle trephine was done at the selected area. And it is freed by the scissor. And this graft was gently placed under air over the macular area with the photoreceptor side down. The rest of the residual fluid was taken out and the donor area was lasered and gas tamponade was given. If we analyze the results, this is a case of a failed macular hole where the graft has been done, and this graft shows, well-taken graft shows that it is placed in the whole area with the hole closed. And there was a resemblance of the retinal architecture also as well. So till now we have managed 7 cases of 6 patients, and of which with a follow-up of minimum of 1 year and maximum of 3.5 years, of which 70% have the graft in place. And 40% of the patient had improved visual acuity, and rest 60% has stable visual acuity, and one patient is able to read newspaper with bright light. The common belief is that the neural tissue cannot be transplanted or regenerated. To find the functional ability of a well-taken graft, we did multifocal ERG. So this is clearly showing a multifocal ERG response in a normal macula. And this is a multifocal ERG response in a case of hole closed with classic ILM peeling technique. This is a failed graft with ILM free ILM filled plug, and this is a graft. The surgery I have shown, the same eye is having this response. We can compare here of all those cases, which is of which the grafting cases is having a very good spike here. And even we did a 10-2 macular threshold value. And this value of macular foveal threshold is almost showing 25, 26, 27 decibel value of the central area of the same eye, which I have shown in the video. This is another case here also, the value is almost 25 to 29 decibel. There is a report where the same kind of retinal flap has been used, but the technique is different, where the free flap has been taken of a larger size and which is placed over the non-closed macular hole, and which is acts like a scaffold, but there is no end-to-end touch. But in our cases, can you
please forward the slide for him?
But in our cases, this is the pre-measured macula. This is the bigger size of the hole. Next one. In our cases, the pre-measured. Can we just continue? The second animation. Please show it.
It's yeah.
Just go back. Let me here. In these cases, we have the pre-measured area, and there is an end-to-end touch. So the hypothesis is that there is an aberrant regeneration between the end-to-end connection, and we have not used any viscoelastic agent as well to prevent this end-to-end hindrance. So there should be an end-to-end touch between the graft host junction. So the hypothetically, this has been proved by the multifocal ERG and other 10-2 macular threshold technique. Yeah, this was the video. Sorry, come to conclusion. Automatically forwarded. Conclusion. So to conclude that this is a new concept of the retinal tissue has been introduced with the better anatomical outcome shown in SDOCT and better functional outcome shown in multifocal ERG and 10-2 macular threshold. But the technique is completely different from the other technique. Here we have used the retinal trephine. The demerit is this is a smaller group of subset of the patient, but being the low incidence, the 7 number is significant enough, but a larger series of analysis can open up the new horizon. This is my references. Thank you.